Northwestern University engineers have developed the smallest ever remote-controlled walking robot, and it comes in the form of a tiny, adorable peekytoe crab. Just a half millimeter wide, the tiny crabs can bend, twist, crawl, walk, turn, and even jump. The researchers also developed millimeter-sized robots resembling inchworms, crickets, and beetles. Although the research is exploratory at this point, the researchers believe their technology might bring the field closer to realizing micro-sized robots that can perform practical tasks inside tightly confined spaces. The research is published in the journal Science Robotics. The researcher says that we might imagine micro-robots as agents to repair or assemble small structures or machines in industry, or as surgical assistants to clear clogged arteries to stop internal bleeding, or to eliminate cancerous tumors, all in minimally invasive procedures. And the researcher says that their technology enables a variety of controlled motion modalities and can walk with an average speed of half its body length per second. This is very challenging to achieve at such small scales for terrestrial robots. Smaller than a flea, the crab is not powered by complex hardware, hydraulics, or electricity. Instead, its power lies within the elastic resilience of its body. To construct the robot, the researchers used a shape memory alloy material that transforms to its remembered shape when heated. In this case, the researchers used a scanned laser beam to rapidly heat the robot at different targeted locations across its body. A thin coating of glass elastically returns that corresponding part of structure to its deformed shape upon cooling. As the robot changes from one face to another, deformed to remembered shape and back again, it creates locomotion. Not only does the laser remotely control the robot to activate it, the laser scanning direction also determines the robot's walking direction. Scanning from left to right, for example, causes the robot to move from right to left. Because these touches are so tiny, the rate of cooling is very fast. In fact, reducing the sizes of these robots allows them to run faster. To manufacture such a tiny critter, the research team turned to a technique they introduced 8 years ago, a pop-up assembly method inspired by a child's pop-up book, bird substrate. When the stitched substrate is relaxed, a controlled buckling process occurs that causes the crab to pop up into precisely defined three-dimensional forms. With this manufacturing method, the Northwestern team could develop robots of various shapes and sizes.